Hello students, today I am again preparing a new video for class 9, first chapter, the fundamental unit of life. And today the topic is ribosome. It is a cell organelle. Today we will study about the ribosomes. Dear students, ribosomes are very small, spherical and granule-like structure. Their diameter varies to 150 angstrom to 250 angstrom. In diameter, they are discovered under the electron microscope and Paillet discovered this in 1955. That's why these are also called as the Paillet particles because of discoverer's name. Paillet particles. On the basis, their diameter is determined, their size of the ribosomes are determined on the basis of sedimentation rate. Sedimentation rate in centrifugal area. Centrifugal area, do you know? Centrifugal machine that used to separate the cream from milk. So in that condition, if we centrifuge the cell fluid, then the ribosome will sediment. Okay? So the rate of sedimentation in the centrifugal field that determine the size of ribosome. Okay? And the unit that determine the centrifugal coefficient is Swedberg, and this extension has been taken to write the name of ribosomes. Once again I am repeating, ribosomes are very small, spherical and granule like structure. Their diameter varies from 150 to 250 angstrom. They are discovered under the electron microscope by Paillet in 1955. That's why they are also called Paillet particles. Their size is determined by the sedimentation rate in the centrifugal field, and the unit in which the sedimentation coefficient is determined is called the Swedberg unit. Now the next step is the occurrence, where they are found inside the cell, inside the body of organism. Dear students, occurrence. Ribosomes are occurring both prokaryotic as well as eukaryotic cells. They are occurring both type of cells. In prokaryotic cells, they are freely floating इन साइटोप्लाज्म, इन प्रोकैरियोट एंड इन यूकैरियोटिक सेल सेल्स दे अकरिंग सेल मैट्रिक्स एट साइटोप्लाज्मिक सरफेस ऑफ रफ इंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड न्यूक्लियर एनवेलप. If you will see these figures, diagrams I delivered earlier, you will see them. Nuclear envelope. Beside this, they are also found in, they are also found in where? In mitochondria and stroma of plastids. They also occurred in stroma of plastids. It means in mitochondria, stroma of plastids, at the cytoplasmic surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum and nuclear envelope, the ribosomes are found in eukaryotic cell, while in prokaryotic cells they are evenly distributed in the form of floating material in cytoplasm of the cell. Okay. How many types there? What are their types? Types. There are two types of ribosomes. And it is on the basis of their size and sedimentation coefficient. On the basis of size and sedimentation coefficient. And those two types are, one is 70S and second is 80S ribosomes. This S stands for Swedberg unit. Okay. This 70S ribosome is found in all prokaryotic cells and matrix of mitochondria and stroma of plastids. You keep in mind 70S ribosomes are found in all prokaryotic cells and stroma of plastids and matrix of mitochondria. They are made of two 50S and 30s sub unit. This is the 70s ribosome. It is found in all prokaryotic cells, and matrix of mitochondria and stroma part of the plastid. They are made up of two subunits, 50s and 30s subunits. Okay. Now, 80s ribosomes. They are found in all eukaryotic cells distributed in cytoplasm and at cytoplasmic surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum and nuclear envelope. This is, they are also made up of two subunits. That is, two subunits are 60s and 40s subunits. They are made up of two subunits, 60s and 40s. This 80s ribosome is found in all eukaryotic cells, distributed in cytoplasm and at the cytoplasmic surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum and nuclear envelope. Cytoplasmic surface of nuclear envelope. They are also made up of two subunits, 60s and 40s subunits. Okay. Now, let's talk about their structure. How they are looks under electron microscope. How they are made up of, this we will study. Structure. All type of ribosomes, whether they are 70s type or 80s type, all are similar in their basic structure. See how the structure is. In this way, suppose this is eukaryotic and this is prokaryotic. This is 60s subunit and this is 40s subunit, and here it is 50s subunit and 30s subunit. They are similar in structure and made of RNA and protein. Chemically they are made up of RNA and protein. RNA stands for ribosomal ribonucleic acid. Okay, it is their structure. Now, their function. What they do? You had heard many times that ribosomes are synthesize the protein inside the cell. Functions. Ribosomes provide space for synthesis of protein in the cells, they are also called protein factory of the cells. Okay, they are called the protein factory of the cells because they provide the space to synthesize the protein inside the cell. Lysosomes. Lysosomes. Okay. Dear students, lysosomes are a spherical body present in the cell responsible for intracellular digestion. Which type of digestion? Intracellular means inside the cell. Intracellular digestion of material. First discovered by C. de Douay in 1949, who named lysosome. The word and soma is different. The lyso word come from the lysis, that means dissolution, and soma word come from soma means body, the body that make dissolution. Lysosome in 1955. Their fine structure is only visible under the electron microscope. Okay. Now, where they are found in the cell, which type of cell have the lysosomes? And that means occurrence. Lysosomes are present in all eukaryotic animal cells, protozoa, fungi, and certain plant cells, not in all, certain plant cells. Okay, absent in prokaryotes and mature mammalian red blood corpuscles. They are absent in prokaryotes and mature mammalian red blood corpuscles, while present in all eukaryotic animal cells, protozoans, fungi and certain plant cells. Lysosomes are present practically. Practically, they are present in these cells. Okay. Generally, they are very less prevalent in plant cells in comparison of animal cells. So many times it has also been said that lysosomes are absent in plant cells. That means they are present in certain plant cells. Generally, we consider them absent. Okay. Now, origin. How they arise? Origin. Lysosomes are arise from Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus. Their membrane and enzymes are synthesized on rough endoplasmic reticulum. What? Membranes and enzymes synthesize at rough endoplasmic reticulum. From rough endoplasmic reticulum, these are transported in transport vesicles. Golgi apparatus arise from lysosomes arise from Golgi apparatus. Their membrane and enzymes are synthesized on rough endoplasmic reticulum. From rough endoplasmic reticulum, they are transported in transport vesicles, bags, to Golgi apparatus for modification and packaging. And this modification and packaging happens in Golgi apparatus. And finally, buds of as primary lysosome. Okay, let's revise. Golgi apparatus arise from Golgi apparatus. Lysosomes arise from Golgi apparatus. Their membrane and enzyme synthesized on rough endoplasmic reticulum. From here, they are transport in transport vesicles to Golgi apparatus for modification and packaging. And finally, they buds off as primary lysosomes from the transphase of Golgi apparatus. You know, cisphase, transphase, you studied earlier. They buds off as primary lysosome from the transphase of Golgi apparatus. Now, let's talk about the structure. How they are structured? Golgi apparatus are bounded in membrane. They are vacuolated membrane bounded cell organelles, and their membrane is made up of lipoprotein. Membrane is made up of lipoprotein, means lipid and protein, lipoprotein. Inside the membrane, there is fine dense granular fluid. Fine granular fluid is present inside. Granular fluid. And do you know this fluid is able to digest, capable to digest all organic matters, organic substances. This fluid is able to digest all organic substances present in cell. Okay. These enzymes, this fluid is called hydrolytic enzyme. Whatever the enzymes are present are called hydrolytic because they are soluble in water and break down the substance in presence of water also. Okay. So they are capable to digest all the organic matter present inside the fluid. Their fluid is capable to digest all organic substance, so there is the risk for the cell itself to become digested. That's why their fluid is membrane bounded and prevented to escape or leak into the cytoplasm and destroying it. Therefore, they are also called suicidal bags. Suicidal bags of cell. Lysosomes are also called suicidal bags of the cell. Okay. Now let's draw a diagram to understand their function. Okay. See carefully how I am drawing. It's quite simple if you will see carefully. Okay. Similarly, in this side, this structure. This structure is called cell membrane, which you know as the name of plasma membrane. Here, there is some structure. In this way. Do you remember this structure? It is the structure of Golgi apparatus. Okay. In this way. And here the ribosomes, because it is rough endoplasmic reticulum and it is the cytoplasmic surface. Inside the cell, whatever is present, that is the part of cytoplasm. Okay. Now, from here, one primary lysosome has been buds off. Here, the secretions which received by the Golgi apparatus and proven harmful are released from outside, released to outside of the cell. We are talking about the single cell thing. Okay. Here they receive some fluid particles and that fluid particle is packed into a vesicle. This vesicle we will call the pinosome. Do you remember? Pinosome. And this process is called pinocytosis. Pinocytosis. Okay. Now here they are absorbing, engulfing the solid particles. This is the phagocytosis. We studied before someday phagocytosis, and they are also packed in a membrane that is called the phagosome. What is phagosome? Some means body. Okay. Now, here is the dead debris of the cell. Okay? And they can be named as the phagosomes. I will explain once more. Now, these all will be collected in one. Okay, this is the enzyme. Some liquid particles comes from here, solid, food, and this phagosomes material. They are finally digested and rest of the useful materials are diffused into the cytoplasm and later word excrete outside of the cell. Rest of the this portion that is blank is of cytoplasm. Okay, this is Golgi apparatus and this portion is the from where the bud snips off. This is the transphase of Golgi apparatus and this is excreted or removed through diffusion. Let's understand it once more. This whole structure you are seeing is the structure of a single cell organism. Let's assume it is a protozoa. Okay, so this membrane is the cell membrane. Okay, inside the cell membrane there is the cytoplasm and other cell organelles. Okay, as I said that they are arises from Golgi apparatus. This is the transphase of Golgi apparatus and this structure you can name it primary lysosome. Okay, primary lysosome, this one. Okay, so from here the primary lysosome arises. The enzymes and vesicles are synthesized at rough endoplasmic reticulum. From here it is transported to Golgi apparatus for modification and after modification it buds off from the transphase of Golgi apparatus in the form of a primary lysosome. Okay, some secretions which are sent by the rough endoplasmic reticulum and proven harmful, unnecessary, they are directly secreted outside of the body of the cell through the diffusion. You know the endocytosis, that is inward movement of the materials. Pinocytosis is the process in which the liquid, that is called cell drinking, liquid are entered into the cell. They are packed into vesicles. These vesicles are called pinosome, inside which the liquid is packed that has taken by the cell. Similarly, one more process of endocytosis is the phagocytosis, in which solid food particles are trapped into the vesicles and these vesicles are called phagosome. If you are not clear, then please see the previous video of osmosis and diffusion. Okay, in bulk transport, not osmosis and diffusion, bulk transport. Okay, there these two are then come inside for the digestion. Here some dead parts, debris of the cell which are unnecessary, they all are collected and then primary lysosome enters into it along with its enzyme, and as I said it is capable to digest all the organic matter that present inside the cell. It is digested here in the form of this, and later what useful material has been released into the cytoplasm and unnecessary harmful material has been released out of the cell. Okay, so in this way the lysosome function in the cell. Okay, let's think about the function. See the video carefully and diagram also. Functions. What functions do they perform? The first function is digestion of useful materials. It is the normal process of nutrition. And you can say we are talking about the endocytosis. Endocytosis that include pinocytosis, cytosis and phagocytosis. It is cell drinking, cell eating. Okay, so liquid materials has been taken through the pinocytosis, solid materials has been taken in the form of by the process of phagocytosis. They all are entered into the cell and digested in the presence of lysosome. So you can say lysosome helps in the digestion of useful materials inside the cell. Okay. Second is the digestion of harmful materials. Okay. What are the harmful materials inside the cell? Sometimes what happens, some foreign particles enter into the cell. Sometimes some foreign particles enter into the cell. Those foreign particles may be viruses, bacteria. Okay. So they are digested by the lysosome, which are present in the cell, and it is the process of phagocytosis. Phagocytosis. By which, as you know, the leukocytes, the white blood cells present in the blood, they do digest the viruses and bacteria which may enter uninvitably in the cell. So they will have the lysosome. So lysosome digests the harmful materials in the body also. Okay. Now unwanted materials are also digested. Third is digestion of unwanted materials. Unwanted materials, suppose after the maturity of the cell it will not able to function properly, then it should be replaced, and instead of this the new membrane, new organelles will be formed. Then how, what happened to the debris, what will happen to the remaining parts of the cell? So that is that that are the unwanted materials and cell debris can be replaced or converted into useful materials, because the previous cell is made from the useful organic materials and inorganic materials, and those materials if released again that will be utilized by the body. So the lysosome help in the dead and decaying remains of the cell, debris of the cell, digested by the lysosomes and again come in the cycle of the cell. Okay, because of this activity the lysosomes are called the scavengers of the cell. Scavengers are housekeeping. Housekeeper of the cell. Okay, and because of this purpose, this activity, they are called the natural defense of the body. They provide the natural defense to the body by digesting the foreign materials. Okay, this and this is the property, means this is the property of simple organisms, the first one, like the unicellular organisms. Okay, while these are rest of the property of higher animals like us. Okay, once again I am repeating, digestion of useful material is done by the lysosomes, and those useful materials may be taken by the in bulk transport, in which the endocytosis, that is the pinocytosis and phagocytosis. Okay, then solid materials or liquid materials digested for the purpose of nutrition. Digestion of harmful materials, uninvited materials, foreign materials like the viruses and bacteria, those can cause the disease. They are killed by the WBC. They will have the lysosomes. Okay, and this provide the natural defense to the body. Third is the digestion of unwanted materials. Unwanted materials, old cells, cells debris or broken part of the cell, they will create the garbage inside the cell. If they will properly managed, then they will come in the use to formation, synthesis of new organelles or new membranes. This lysosome help in digesting the cell debris and make them their components free to use again. So because of this purpose, because of this activity, they are called the scavengers or housekeeping. Besides this, during the period of starvation, you know, bhookhmari, when there is the crisis of food, lack of food, that period is the starvation. So during starvation, they digest their own, means of self, own fats, carbohydrates and other components. Carbohydrates and other components may be cell itself to provide the energy. This happens to provide energy for body activity, energy for activities, many activities are there, okay, and such type of activity is called autophagy, means self-killing. This is called the autophagy, and because of this activity, they are also called the suicidal bags. Okay, they digest themselves, they digest their own cell materials in the case of starvation. So these are the main functions of the lysosomes. Besides this, some important features, like one, as you know, metamorphosis, like it is reported in frog. Do you know, frog lay eggs and eggs converted into tadpole and tadpole into frog. This tadpole is similar to the structure of fish. They will have the tail, okay? And the frog, the structure of the frog is completely different from the tadpole. The tails and other unnecessary organs, when tadpole is converting into frog, that process is the metamorphosis. During that process, the unnecessary organs of tadpole are digested by the lysosomes and the use in the transformation of the organs into new organs. Okay, so lysosomes are also help in metamorphosis. Besides this, they also help in fertilization. How they help in fertilization? As you know, the acrosome are the head of the sperms where the lysosomes are present, and those lysosomes that are present at the head of the sperms, acrosomes, it help in the penetrating, digesting the wall of ovum. Suppose this is ovum and this will be the acrosome of the sperm in this way. So this wall will digested and sperms are able to enter their nuclei in the ovum by the presence of lysosomes. Okay, so they help in the fertilization also. Okay, so their functions are digestion of useful materials, digestion of harmful materials, digestion of unwanted materials, and help the body during starvation by digesting its own components, the components of the cell. Besides this, they also help in metamorphosis and fertilization,